Help us to treasure, Lord, our heritage of learning, and inspire us to be willing to use that learning to your glory and the good of all mankind. Bless us, Lord, as we gather this day with your gift of love, as we share this event with these young people.
Thank you very much. Well, as I came in here today, they handed me a program. When I opened it up, the first thing I saw on the right-hand side was something that says, if we have the ability to dream of what lies ahead for us, then we have the ability to succeed. These 52 young graduates call that their class motto. As they were walking in and coming down the aisle today, and everybody stood up and turned towards the center, as we could sit up here on the stage and see all the smile on the faces of these 52 young people as they came down the aisle, you could just as easily see all the smiles on the faces of the people that turned and looked towards them as they were. You never thought you'd really get to see this day. You worked hard at it. You've had some of these young ladies and gentlemen for 17, 18, 19 years. And there have been days when they didn't want to get up and go to school. And there are days when you as parents felt they weren't quite as sick as they thought they were. And there are days that you knew that once you got them to school, their ailments for the day would get better. Because as it approached the evening, they would be cured. And there isn't a single one of you that isn't here today with a great deal of pride, and at the same point, just a certain amount of sadness. Because they're no longer your little boy and your little girl. After today, they're the new adults of this community, and they're the new adults of South Dakota. One of the unfortunate things about a graduation exercise is that none of these 52 young men and women are going to be seen tonight on the 6 o'clock or the 10 o'clock news. You're not going to see them on the front page of the Watertown Public Opinion or the Brookings Daily Register. Why? Because they're not hurting anybody. They're not destroying anything, and they're not a threat to anyone. And so that's not the kind of news that makes the front page. What you see up here are 52 young men and women, none of whom has to be here. Every single one of them up on this stage has since passed the time when the law required them to go to school. They could have quit, and they didn't. They could have failed, but they decided they were going to succeed. And one of the great things about going through the type of public education that we offer in a rural state like South Dakota is they've come together in their final exercise as friends. Starts today. And so as I said a few moments ago to you 52 young graduates, we in South Dakota expect a great deal from you. We in South Dakota believe that you're going to be part of not just our future, but the solution to our future's problems. We in South Dakota feel that you're ready to assume your rightful role as members of the adult community, with the responsibility to help guide your generation and the generations to follow you. We in South Dakota take a great deal in the fact, I should say a great deal of pride in the fact, that we not only know that you're ready, we not only know that you're up to the measure, but just as importantly, we know that with this credo you've set for yourself, you're going to be part of a successful future. Because you have given yourself lifelong charge and responsibility by saying that since you have the ability to dream of what lies ahead for yourselves, then you have the ability to succeed. Thank you very much.
Bart G. Fisher. Charles D. Aderhold. Jill Marie Anderson. Lisa Renee Anderson. Mark Allen Byard. Marcia Marie Byard. Scott Lee Collins. Trevor Lynn Kramer. Jared W. Dorr. Janae Ann Dumpke. David Lee Glennell. Sandra K. Eshe. Guy W. Yager. Sherry Lynn Geiser. Betty Jo Goins. Jennifer Goodroad. Brad Michael Goodroad. Terry Joe Roadhouse. Henny Lee Hine. Jolynn Diane Hoffman. Corbin D. Hughes. Candy Renee Jensen. Ryan Scott Kelly. Julie Hope Jensen. Brett M. Kennedy. James J. Kraus. Douglas Edwin Lanners. James Dennis Lanners. Lisa Ray Larson. Sarah Marie Lisby. Connie Ray Meyer. Jeff John Neiman. Shara Joy Neiman. Thomas Michael Peterson. Monrad Peterson. Danny Robert Schmall. Lenora K. Schumacher. Michael John Siegfried. Michael J. Smith.
have to go? Does it have to end? Must it be goodbye? Tell me, can't you stay a while? You have been a friend. Please forgive the lie. Love is never what they tell us in songs. Life is often just a string of wrongs. I must have an ear in me. I can't live. Please don't go away. Tell me that we'll love again, that the storm is past, that you feel my pain. Tell me what I want to hear, that no die is cast and the way is clear. Love is often what they tell us in songs, and together we will cling on. I must have an ear in me. I can't live the day. My poor heart is weary. Please don't go away. See my love, a tear of you, add a bar of rest, no some sorrow die. Through my visca of you, ache is on some cest, die I ache from die. Guide in all the risk, and I so and then, on the other man. No atida nena, till I see adieu. See my love, tear of you, come the poverty, I'm of that for me. Through my visca taught you, visa shalihet. On the shiller's head, yeah, I will all the husker dies on and then. On the Aldri Mera says, yeah, we have all a meaner. Did it Aldri do? No, I did a meaner. Till I see, adieu, adieu.